Imagine a futuristic society in which you can actually genetically engineer every single individual. This is typically portrayed as some dystopian futuristic society in science fiction films, but it turns out that technology is slowly progressing to the point that we can actually do this, which opens up a huge portion of ethical debates. So we're going to be talking about how modified human embryos reignite this whole debate. In May 2015, Chinese researchers performed gene editing on human embryos in order to correct a blood disorder called beta thalassemia using this new CRISPR-Cas9 gene editing technology. And this brings up this issue because in the past there's been genetic diseases in which you might think maybe it would be better if we could treat these before the individual is even born as opposed to trying to come up with a treatment afterwards. In addition to beta thalassemia, another disease that was popularized in the media was leukodystrophy. So Lorenzo Odone was an individual that was diagnosed with leukodystrophy, or LD, at the age of 6. And this disease is characterized by degeneration of white matter in the brain. So Lorenzo had a rare version of LD known as adrenoleukodystrophy, or ALD, which is caused by mutations on the X chromosome. And patients of ALD gradually become mute, deaf, blind, and paralyzed. And the reason why this gained so much media attention is because Lorenzo's parents actually created this controversial cocktail known as Lorenzo's Oil, that was able to actually help treat Lorenzo. It didn't cure him, but it helped reduce the symptoms for quite some time. And this was actually popularized in a film known as Lorenzo's Oil. So similar to beta thalassemia, LD and ALD are also genetic disorders. They're diseases caused by mutations in an individual's genome. Another individual that we should talk about is Sam Burns. So Sam Burns was diagnosed with progeria, which is characterized by rapid premature aging, and he was diagnosed with it at the age of 2. So progeria is caused by a single mutation in the lamin A gene, which results in destabilizing the cell membrane, which harms the skeletal and muscular systems. So Sam became famous because he was one of the first people that had this disease and actually went to the public and talked about it. So he gave a TEDx talk, and he was also constantly in the news trying to disseminate information about this priorly not very well-known disease. So again, another disease that's caused by a mutation in an individual's genome. And the last person we'll talk about is Massimo. Massimo Damiani was a child who lost the ability to talk and crawl when he was a year old. Scientists sequenced the genomes of Massimo and his parents, this what we call a genome trio, a mother, father, and child, and they figured out that this disease was actually caused by a new mutation not present in either parent that this child had developed on his own.